I am Pastor Dr. Mrs. Obed of Glory Tabernacle Ministry. I'm the Pioneer Associate Pastor of this ministry, the one also in charge of the discipleship program of our church. Since my husband and I met Daddy Gio in the 80s, we've seen various facets of his life. I would like to say to you that here you come meeting a true man of God, a genuine servant of God, a man whose heart is fully to do the will of God, to make sure he brings as many people as possible to follow to heaven. He's a man of integrity, he's a man of deep dedication. When the School of Disciples in Redeemed Church started for the first time, it was started in the camp and we were in class one. The first set that did the School of Disciples, he would teach all through the evening till about 12 midnight, and then all of us would go out to work. That was when the camp was being developed. As we are carrying bags of cement, he too is carrying it. We are carrying buckets of water, he too is joining us to carry it. And for the next 2 hours plus, we are all working. Some of the little buildings in the camp were simply built by the School of Disciples in a class, because he was trying to make sure that the things he was teaching us were practices of it. And so he is showing us an example. So he's a man who is a model. He's a man, a model of righteousness, a model of deep humility and deep meekness of heart. He's a man who simply loved God. And that's why my husband and I are very much associated with him. You cannot follow Pastor Adeboye and miss going to heaven. It is not possible. It's not possible. So there's too much. Is it hard work? Is it hard work? He's a man who works so hard. He's a man of prayer. Of course, I know, for those of you who live in camp and can afford to walk around in the middle of the night, you will see a single man who is trekking long distances. All he's doing is intercession. So we want to thank God for the ideas God had given him to be able to run the Redeemed Church. We are glad to be associated with him and to be a follower of him too. Yes, please. You will have to refer to him as almost covering all the areas, because he is first and foremost a pastor. And if I understand, I'm a pastor, but I do not operate in all the gifts of the work of shepherding. But for Pastor Adeboye, he operates, he's a teacher. Truly, he is a prophet. Prophet in his, not the kind of things we see today. He's a prophet who will not make a statement that God didn't say. And so, a prophet is someone who stands between God and the people. So he is a man who is a prophet. When he speaks, those words are true. Watch out for it, wait for it, they will certainly come to pass. So it is not abnormal to say that he is a prophet. He's an apostle of God's people. See what's going on around the world. Tell me any country in the world that you go to and there is not a Redeemed Church. Pastor and I have ministered in many of the Redeemed Churches abroad, in many countries. So he's an apostle, always breaking up new grounds. So whatever you like to call him is the angle you've met him with. He's an evangelist. In the early days of, all the big meetings, the Holy Ghost services, when he stands to minister as an evangelist, you cannot fault him. So it is not if you say that, he occupies all those offices, but he is originally called as a pastor, the shepherd of God's people, and he is doing that extremely well. A true prophet is a man who is in the place of intercession. And you can't fault that you are in that. It's not possible. It is just not possible. You can't catch him unawares. He's a man who knew what it meant to come into the presence of God. That's a great intercessor. So when you think about all these, he very much qualifies. It is true he keeps himself as low, as humble as he could possibly be, which is what we should expect a genuine servant of God to be. That's what we should expect. So I want to really thank God because he qualifies for any of the offices that we've mentioned. He is a great prophet. If you take note, I don't know about others, when I sit under his teaching, I am a fast writer. I take note of the things he says, and I watch them. Those things he says in the group or to you as a person, they cannot but be fulfilled. And he is not a frivolous person, unlike the kinds of prophets we have today. We have prophets, they are speaking to you, not because they are hearing from God, but because of what you've got and they want to take it. Daddy Joe is not that kind of person. Whether you give him or you don't give him, he's not ministering to you because of what you will give to him. No, because he is a great giver himself. He gives everybody whatever it is you meet on the field. Take it, but go on and don't look back. Jesus still is Lord. It without controversy, Jesus remains Lord. And it is, of course, not what people will say that will determine whether our message is good. Because many people are operating by different kinds of spirits. But for us to win souls, let us go ahead and speak. Provided we have used the place of prayer to bring in the people. Because when you do a lot of intercession, I promise you, you would have people to be saved. So don't let anybody discourage you as a soul winner. Don't. It doesn't matter to me. I don't get discouraged. I have every opportunity, and I'm maximizing that opportunity. The truth is, some will come to Christ. May I say, if you have not come to Christ, you're wasting time. The reason is very simple. Jesus will soon arrive. There is no controversy about it. The coming of Jesus is very certain. So it will be a loss for anybody that the trumpet will sound and you are not ready. It will be a great loss. And so we want to encourage anybody who has not come to the true knowledge of Jesus to receive him as personal savior and the Lord of your life. I want to encourage you, make haste now. Ask somebody, please lead me, I want to know Christ. Because both myself, who is preaching, and you yourself, who doesn't know anything, Jesus says to us, we do not know the time he will come. But will he come? Certainly, yes. Jesus is arriving very soon. And you said to me, how do I know? Check Matthew chapter 24, chapter 25. Check the Gospels, all the things they have said are fulfilling. Even if you have never read the Bible, what is happening in today's world tells you that Jesus will say, come. So I encourage you, don't let the devil deceive you to tell you that there's still so much to enjoy here. There's nothing to enjoy. I encourage you, make haste and receive Christ Jesus. You will be better off for it. I told my friends a few days ago, we went out to do evangelism and discipleship in one of the towns near Oyo. And I was telling them early in the morning, the best thing that can happen to anybody is to be a Christian. And that's the best thing that has happened in my life since a young girl to be a Christian. No regrets. So we want to ask anybody, boy, girl, daddy, mommy, you've not received Christ. Run. There are still good churches. You yourself, we know there are good churches. Get to those churches, ask to see the leaders, or ask for any member of the church. They will lead you to Christ. And that's the truth. You must be urgent about it. Jesus is arriving soon. We know that it is the devil at work to discourage the church. The Bible tells us in Psalm 133 how good and how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity. It is the will of God that all of us, it doesn't matter, I belong to Glory Tabernacle, I belong to Redeemed, I belong to this, I belong to that. The truth is, in every congregation, there is a remnant. And we've got to begin to look for the remnant to be in harmony, to be in unity. We want to encourage people to come together as one. We want to do so. It is unfortunate that every church goes about advertising their church, establishing their church, but it is possible to go do the work of ministry without putting your church first. That's where the problem is. And so as a result, you know, many people want to gather their people because they're thinking of money. If we don't have our people, how will we get our money? And some are discouraging people from attending things that are good. I tell, for example, I just came in from the Feast of Esther, and we were almost 2,000 women from across the world, almost all the states in this country. And that's what the body of Christ is supposed to be. Nobody in all the ministrations, in all that we did at the Feast of Esther, nobody was talking about any church. Not even to say Redeemed Church, except that one or two people had to thank God that Redeemed Church made the place available for our use at really, you know, no pay, even though we know there's a pay, and our mommy Gio, you know, would always upset all those. So it is not the church. When you get to the pearly gates of heaven, according to scripture, they're not going to ask you, which church are you coming out from? So may God enable members of our church, and particularly our leaders, because the problem is coming from all the pastors, the leaders, because they put their churches first. It's not your church first. It is the body of Christ first. All we are supposed to do, get back to our churches and prepare the body that is worshiping in that location they call the Glory Tabernacle Ministry. It's simply a location. The church is the bride of Christ, and there is only one bride. And when the trumpet sounds, the bride will come from all over the faces of the world, and we'll meet Jesus in the air, and from there we'll go up to heaven with him. Daddy, I don't know what you would like, you know, those of us who have grown under you, to say to you. First of all, I would like to thank you very much for the way you have cared for me and my husband, even up to his death. I want to say thank you for being there for not just us, but for several people. Thank you for being an instrument that God could afford to pass through, because that's exactly what is going on. God uses you, passes through you, and reaches out to the entire world. I'm sure that I'm saying the obvious. You know that is the truth, because that is what has been in your heart. And I want to say thank you for being God's own servant, God's own under shepherd, because that's what you have been You've been an under shepherd under the Most High God to make sure that many servants of God are groomed and are trained. I want to thank you for giving all your time for that. And we want to thank God for keeping you in good health. And we want to thank God because we know that you will make it to heaven. It is not a wish. It is that we know. Because we know, and I know, that you're not going to let go the work and Jesus that you have clutched to. We pray to God that Jesus will keep you well. We thank God for a blessing you have been to the Church of God worldwide. And we're trusting God that you will live many more years and it will be in good health. Thank you for all the books you have written, and thank you for all the magazines, and thank you for your thoughts, and thank you for just being there for us many. And we pray for you. You know it, that my husband and I have a one day in a week we pray for you and for mommy. Even though he's not there now, I have maintained that day. It is not enough, but I just want to assure you there are people who are sincere enough to lift you before the throne of God. Thank you, Daddy. Thank you for being who you are to us. We bless you. In Jesus' name. Amen.